"The Methodists allow women to preach," said Captain Jim. Miss Cornelia glared at him. "I never said the Methodists hadn't common sense, Captain. What I say is, I doubt if they have much religion."
"I suppose you're in favor of votes for women, Miss Cornelia," said Gilbert.
"I'm not hankering after the vote, believe me," said Miss Cornelia scornfully. "I know what it is to clean up after the men. But some of these days, when the men realize they've got the world into a mess they can't get it out of, they'll be glad to give us the vote, and shoulder their troubles over on us. That's their scheme. Oh, it's well that women are patient, believe me."
"What about Job?" suggested Captain Jim.
"Job? It was such a rare thing to find a patient man that when one was really discovered they were determined he shouldn't be forgotten," retorted Miss Cornelia triumphantly. "Anyhow, the virtue doesn't go with the name. There never was such an impatient man born as old Job Taylor over harbor."
"Well, you know, he had a good deal to try him, Cornelia. Even you can't defend his wife. I always remember what old William McAllister said of her at her funeral. There's nae doot she was a Christian woman, but she had the Dale's own temper."
"I suppose she was trying," admitted Miss Cornelia reluctantly, "but that didn't justify what Job said when she died. He rode home from the graveyard the day of the funeral with my father. He never said a word till they got near home. Then he heaved a big sigh and said, 'You may not believe it, Stephen, but this is the happiest day of my life.' Wasn't that like a man?"
"I suppose poor old Mrs. Job did make life kinder uneasy for him," reflected Captain Jim.
"Well, there's such a thing as decency, isn't there? Even if a man is rejoicing in his heart over his wife being dead, he needn't proclaim it to the four winds of heaven. And happy day or not, Job Taylor wasn't long in marrying again, you might notice. His second wife could manage him. She made him walk Spanish, believe me. The first thing she did was to make him hustle round and put up a tombstone to the first Mrs. Job, and she had a place left on it for her own name. She said there'd be nobody to make Job put up a monument to her.